Hold on a sec. I have to ask you something. Gary, I broke up with him 3 weeks ago. The sex was okay, but he was kind of limited. No. It wasn't that Gary was bad in bed. I mean, he knew where all the parts were. Unfortunately, most of them were his. Yes, totally passionless. It was like he was thinking of someone else. I know I was. Somebody's here. I gotta go. All right, I'll talk to you later. Bye, Mom.
That was your mother?
Yeah, why?
You talk to your mother like that?
Well, we're both adults. We talk about everything.
Well, isn't that healthy?
So, I step out of the shower, I look out the window, and I notice the garbage man looking right in at me. So I say, did you get a good look? And he says, not completely, turn around. Then he smiles, and he's missing a tooth, and that's when the romance went right out of it for me.
Well, you look nice.
Yeah? Well, I've got a date tonight.
Oh, great. Oh, why are you wearing only one heel, Abby? Did you break it off?
No. I'm dating a sea captain with a peg leg, and this makes it easier when we dance. Broke it off on a sidewalk, great.
Okay, so who is this guy? Another one of those trendy young kids who's got three earrings, a ponytail, wearing a t-shirt under his sports coat?
Is he here?
Right, where do you meet these people?
For your information, this guy happens to be a very successful media consultant. He graduated from Princeton, he has a house on Mercer Island, and he owns a 40-foot sailboat.
You met him on a bus, didn't you?
No, actually, we shared a cab. All right, he was driving it.
Hello, Frasier.
Hi, Niles. You remember Ross?
Yes, of course. What brings you here?
Oh, nothing. Just passing by and thought I'd stop in for a career.
Good luck. Sorry I'm late, Frasier, but the entrance to your parking garage is blocked by a cab driver with a ponytail scraping gum off his back seat.
Madam, your chariot awaits.
Well, these things happen.
These things happen? Roz, how can you say that? My God, this was not an old man. He was my age.
What am I supposed to say? I guess I just don't think about these things like you do. Maybe it's because you're 41 and I'm not.
Don't you ever think about your own mortality? Don't you ever think about dying?
Well, not me dying, but you know what I have thought about lately? I've been dating this older guy, and what if, you know, we were in bed together and he dropped dead? Well, it's not out of the realm of possibility. Sometimes he starts breathing really funny, and I don't know if he's having a good time or if I've just overexcited him to some dangerous level.
Someone certainly has a very high opinion of herself.
Everybody's good at something.
Ross, why is that every time we try to have a serious discussion, we end up talking about your sex life?
Because I have one.
Well, Ross, I thought that was a pretty good show, didn't you?
Yeah, sure, whatever you say.
Seem a bit distracted there, Ross. You got another one of your hot dates?
You must know, yes.
Pick you up outside in 5 minutes?
Great. Thanks, Noel.
Noel Shemsky from sales, that's who your date's with?
Well, it's not a date. We're just going out for a drink, okay?
Noel the mole?
I know he's not great looking. I know he drives a 73 Dodge Polaris. But he's just always struck me as a really interesting guy.
Mm-hmm.
Look, the world is loaded with superficial guys. You know, I just wanted to try going out with someone who has a good heart. He's smart. He's substantial. And, you know, considering my track record lately, I would hope you'd support me. Is that asking too much?
Does Noel still have that autographed picture of Captain Kirk in his cubicle?
Why do I tell you anything?
Hey, TJ, how was it, man?
It was horrible. They're like sharks in a feeding frenzy. The one who bought me had this crazed look in her eye.
Where do I pay?
Ross!
I saw what I wanted and I went after it. Stay. You want to hear the greatest part? I've already got a date for the ceremony. Brad McNamara.
The Channel 8 reporter? Television's most handsome man.
Yes. Yeah. You know, for months he wouldn't give me the time of day, but one little nomination and he knew who I was. Who are
you.
Oh, hello, Roz.
Daphne.
Roz!
Congratulations.
Oh, thanks. You know, I couldn't believe it myself. Brad McNamara.
Roz, I believe she was referring to your CB nomination.
No, I meant Brad McNamara. Oh, do you think he wears any pants under that desk?
Not on my TV. Frasier, this is a very big night for me, so please, please don't spoil it by making fun of who I brought.
I thought you were bringing Brad McNamara.
Well, I was, but he got called out on a story at the last minute. Some hospital went up in flames. Do you know anyone who has worse luck than I do?
Hi, Dr. Crane.
Mel Shevsky's your day?
Mm-hmm. Tip, Dr. Crane? If you're ever nominated again, there's a metered parking lot 3 blocks away. They don't check after 6. Oh, here are the car keys, so you can drive us home. I have night blindness.
I wish I did. Hey, Frasier, how was your weekend?
Hellish.
Great. So let me tell you what happened to me. See, I had this most incredible date Saturday night. It was really hot. Mm-hmm. So Sunday, I'm driving home.
Sunday?
I told you it was hot. So anyway, my car breaks down right in front of this church, mm-hmm. and all the people are just coming out after their show.
No, service.
What?
Churches don't have shows, they have services.
Can I finish my story?
All right, all right.
Thank you. So I walk up to the minister, is that all right? Mm-hmm. And I ask him if I can use his phone. And he tells me my sweater's on inside out. One thing led to another, and we have a date tonight. Ministers aren't celibate, are they? Not that I don't love a challenge.
You know, Roz, maybe you should take a sick day sometime, call into the show yourself.
You're on the air.
Asking to let him have her time slot while she was on vacation. When she got back, she had been banished to the midnight to 4 a.m. slot.
What are you saying? He's trying to take our time slot?
No, I'm just saying we should watch our backs. How would you like to work from midnight to 4 a.m.? What would happen to your social life? Those are your peak hours.
I came here to get coffee.
No. Thanks for stopping by. I'd have been mad if you didn't.
I'm also meeting someone here.
Oh, let me guess. A man?
Yes.
Yeah.
The new guy from the news department, Andy Winslow. He's really cute. He caught me checking him out when he was bending over the water fountain.
Ah, love at first sight.
Anyway, he said, why don't we get some coffee and get to know each other? I don't know, Frasier. I've got a strange feeling that this guy might be the one.
Oh, Ross, honey. You say that about every guy you meet. Let's just see if this one calls back.
Yeah, I guess. You know, I don't think he's here yet. I think I'll go snag a table.
Good luck. Bye, Roz.
Yeah.
Look, that must be Roz's coffee companion. Wow. He's really handsome, isn't he?
Wow. Did you say wow?
Good Lord, I did. I don't think I've ever said wow describing another man before. I wonder if that means something.
Oh, absolutely. It means you're a gay man. Your life with Maris is a big charade, and you should have come out of the closet years ago. You want to tell Dad, or shall I?
Well, I guess the best way I could think of saying it is that I...
Oh, this sucks.
Well, what's the matter?
You think you're going to sit down with somebody and have a cup of coffee and that they might, just might, lead you to something like, oh, I don't know, a life? Suddenly the trap door opens and you're right back in Roz's world.
How did it go so wrong so quickly?
Simple. He didn't want to date me. He wanted to convert me. I don't have anything against religious people. I don't care if they're Jewish or a Jehovah's Witness or a Buddhist. I am ecumenical. I embrace men of all faiths.
If only it stopped there.
But he pretended he was going to ask me out. Now, isn't there a commandment against that?
No, they didn't go into dating until the New Testament.
Oh, Roz, I'm sorry. Why don't you join us?
No, thank you. There's a cute new handyman in my building. Thought I'd just go home, slip into a negligee, and rip out my faucet.
You think she's kidding, don't you?
You know, Roz, it's entirely possible that there is a a dog lover inside you that's just dying to get out. Don't you think so? Come on.
Just take a look. Come on, take a look.
He's adorable. Oh, come here, little fella. Oh, aren't you the cutest little thing? Oh, yeah. Give me a kiss. Oh, I love you too. Oh.
There. Happy now.
Ross, how can you just toss him aside after such a tender display of affection?
I can do it with men, too.
Come on, Frasier, it's time to start the show.
Well, I know what your problems are. What are Daphne's?
Daphne? Oh, she's just having trouble finding men.
Oh, say no more.
No, Ross, no, please, really, it's not necessary. You do not have to donate one of your boyfriends to Daphne.
I'd be happy to.
Still, one hates to break up a collection.
Sven Bachman. He's an aerobics instructor.
I don't think so.
Oh, this one's perfect. Gunther Dietrich. Oh, he's loads of fun, and he's a runway model.
A German narcissist. There's an appealing combination.
Okay, I'll keep looking.
Looking for what?
I'm helping Frasier find a man for Daphne. Here we go. He's a tennis instructor, and his name is Brick.
Dear God, Frasier, Sven, Gunther, Brick. Why not just lather Daphne up with baby oil and hurl her over the wall of a prison yard?
Excuse me, but I've dated all these guys.
Well, where do you think I came up with the imagery?
Listen, you little titmouse.
All right, now listen, Niles, you are completely out of line here, and Roz, he does have a point. You and Daphne are entirely different kinds of women. While Daphne is very shy and inexperienced, you're more, well, a lot more. Well, actually, you'd be hard-pressed to find anyone who's more...
Oh, I get it. Not one man I've ever dated is good enough for Miss Daphne. Is that what you're trying to say?
No, that is what I'm trying not to say. You're not making it very easy. Look at this. My so-called windproof umbrella. They're just as well as one of those little paper ones they put in Polynesian drinks.
Oh, I got a big collection of those. They remind me of wonderful evenings that I can't remember. You know, when I was a girl, I considered being a nun.
Really? What changed your mind?
I didn't want to work weekends.
Yeah, Patterson's great. His reapportionment plan makes a lot of sense.
Forget it, Roz. He's happily married.
Of course, it doesn't help that I didn't get any sleep last night.
Dating a snorer?
You know, Frasier, I'm getting just a little tired of your constant insinuation that I sleep around. I didn't get any sleep because of that idiot, Chopper Dave. When he gets bored doing traffic reports, he likes to buzz people's apartments in his helicopter.
Oh, I can see how that would be annoying.
Well, it didn't bother me much, but the guy I was with is a Vietnam vet, and he started having flashbacks.
You know, we went out again last night, and it's just perfect between us. We talk, we can laugh at the same
thing. Just stop. Did it ever occur to you that since I'm in one of the worst dating droughts of my entire adult life, that to hear you prattling on like a giggling schoolgirl about your storybook romance might be the teensiest bit irritating?
No, it hadn't, and you're right, Roz. I'm sorry. Sometimes I can be so insensitive. But, you know, Madeline's helping me with that. She is so good. She is so good in, like, every way.
I'm sorry.
It's just that I haven't felt this way since my divorce. Everything seems so right. You know, I haven't said this out loud, but here goes. It's possible that she could be the woman I spend the rest of my life with.
Go do that. Get married. Have a couple of kids. Move out to the country. Buy a puppy. Live happily ever after.
Just don't tell me about it. I need a boyfriend.
Dear Roz. Dear silly Roz. Dear silly horny Roz. I'm listening.
Yeah, I'm really having a problem with women.
Frasier, Madeline's on line one.
Dr. Crane.
Vic, something's come up in the booth. I'll have to turn you over to my very capable producer.
Okay.
Madeline, hi. Oh, thanks for calling.
Oh, no, no, it's okay. It's okay. I'm off the air right now.
So, Vic, what's this trouble you're having with women?
I don't know. You know, I have a good job. I think I have a good personality. Of course, I made more money when I was modeling, but I'm doing okay at the law firm.
Tell me more.
No, those.
Oh, just extra copies of your schedule.
Why are you running down to the Xerox room for extra copies of my schedule? Wouldn't have anything to do with that new intern, would it? What's his name?
Eli.
Ross, he's probably all of 19.
That's legal.
Well, cuckoo-ca-choo, Mrs. Robinson.
Frasier, the guy is so gorgeous. You just want to bite him all over.
Haven't you seen him?
No, I've been eating out lately. Not seriously thinking of dating him, are you?
Why is it all right for older men to date younger women, but it's not okay for older women to date younger men?
Don't make the rules, Roz. I just enjoy them.
Ron, question. I want you to give me an honest answer.
No, that outfit does not make you look fat.
Well, that wasn't the question. Why would you think it was?
Well, as a rule, when a woman prefaces a question with, I want an honest answer, that's usually the question.
Well, I'm not that insecure.
All right. I'm sorry. You're right. Your question, please.
Would you say the back of my head is unattractive?
Ross, have you completely lost your mind?
No, I'm serious. You know how I have season tickets to the Seahawks games? Mm-hmm. Well, there's this really cute guy who sits right behind me. And a few weeks ago, we said hi and we smiled at each other. But so far, he hasn't asked me out yet. So I was thinking maybe there was something, you know, weird about the back of my head.
Ross, there could be hundreds of reasons why he hasn't asked you out.
Thank you. That makes me feel much better.
No. Maybe he's married. Maybe he's in a relationship. Maybe he's gay. Or maybe he's there to watch a football game and not cruise chicks.
Okay, you're right. Being ridiculous.
Of course you are. See you Monday.
All right. I saw that.
You see, Dr. Crane, there's this man I'd like to go out with, but he's 40 years old and he's never been married. Do you think that means something?
Well, it could mean he has a fear of commitment, or it could mean he's just been lucky. Marie, that was a joke.
Did I mention I'm calling from a payphone?
Oh, well, all right, Marie. I would say give him a shot, but I'd keep that caution bulb lit. Thank you for your call, Marie. Who's next, Ross?
If you ask me, it's divorced people you have to watch out for. If someone's never been married, it might just mean they're a careful shopper. Whereas your divorcee will bite into any old piece of fruit without even giving it a squeeze first.
The preceding was an unbiased opinion from my never-been-married producer, Roz, who incidentally has squeezed more fruit than Tropicana.
So, Roz, are you going to join us?
No, I think I'll just go sit over here.
Roz, are you trying to avoid me?
Well, can you blame me? I mean, it took you nearly a year just to learn my name, and every time we sit together, you have some kind of snide remark to make.
Name one.
Well, last week you told me my bedroom was easier to get into than a community college.
I was hoping that would be the one you'd name.
So this is the Sam Malone you've always talked about, the one who has no respect for women and treats them like dirt. Anyone to show you around Seattle?
Well, you know, tell you the truth, I'm all right with the city, but I get real lost in my hotel room.
Oh, boy. Just look at the two of you face to face.
I imagine wild animals all over the Northwest are lifting their heads, alerted to the scent. Goodbye, Ron.
Well, if you need me company, give me a call. Here's my number.
Oh, thanks. That's a snazzy card.
Yes, glows in the dark.
So do I. Same old story. Love triumphs over Roz.
Oh, Roz, don't be a sore loser, will you?
3 months ago, didn't Sam say they'd been together for 6 months?
Well, it looks like this horse race is on again.
Oh, put the weapon down! Stop it, Roz. Have you no scruples whatsoever?
You're the one who slept with your friend's fiance.
Well, I didn't know that at the time. Hear her side of this story. I mean, after all, there are hundreds of reasons why people have affairs.
Roz, want to get us started?
So, Niles, you randy dog, you got lucky last night, didn't you? I can always tell. Oh, don't worry, you'll meet somebody.
If he gets into that club, I should too.
Well, what if I happen to know someone very high up who could probably get you invited to that cocktail party?
Oh, Roz, don't toy with me.
Mr. Strickland, please. Just tell him it's Roz.
Walter Strickland Jr.?
Senior.
Oh, Ross, how did you ever get to know someone so important?
The less you know, the happier you'll be. So my mom says, how can you never bring your boyfriends out to meet me? And I say, Mom, the plane trip to Wisconsin takes 4 hours, and that's longer than most of my relationships last.
Is there something wrong?
Yes, I told a guy I love him.
Somebody you know this time?
Forget it, Frasier. I know you don't like to hear about my love life.
Oh, Ross, don't be ridiculous. I care about you. If you have a problem and I can help, I'd love to. Just keep the details on a need-to-know basis.
Okay. We've been dating a couple of weeks, and last night he started licking me behind my ear. You see, I had this sweet little spot.
Ross, is this...
Yes, you do need to know this. So anyway, what I meant to say was... Oh, I love that. But I got so caught up that I yelled out, oh, I love you. And then all of a sudden he got this look on his face like Indiana Jones running from the big ball.
Well, Roz, do you love him?
No, but I said it, so he should have said it back. It's just polite.
There is no more emotionally charged phrase in the language than I love you. Some people are just incapable of saying it. It makes them too vulnerable. My father, for instance, incapable of saying I love you. Even to me. But I know he does.
So your father never told you he loves you? God, that explains so much.
What is that supposed to mean?
Well, maybe if he had, you wouldn't be so emotionally needy that when a close friend asks your advice, you have to steer the conversation back to your own problems. So anyway, now that I told this guy I love him, how do I take it back?
Very simple, Ross. Do you remember when I said that I cared about you and I'd like to help?
Yeah?
I take it back. Possible that I broke that woman's heart.
Ooh, whose heart did you break?
No one. Niles, be quiet.
Oh, come on, Frasier. I'm gonna figure it out sooner or later. Give me a clue. Just one. That's all I need.
Doc, come quick. Phoebe's out on the ledge of our building. She's threatening to jump.
Oh, my God. This is all my fault.
Wait, just give me a hint.
Oh, Niles, guess what? Thriving Seattle night spot is closing its doors.
Roz, you're moving.
They want the sole Veronica without the grapes. Spinach instead of broccoli and risotto instead of pasta. They also want the swordfish, but hold the capers.
Oh, for heaven's sakes, can't you just tell them no substitutions?
I have trouble saying no.
So the guidebooks tell us.
I'm the dullest person because...
Oh, I don't know, because I've never made love in a lift or a phone booth or on an aeroplane or a merry-go-round.
All right, well, that's good, but strategically speaking, that's not the best way to get our pennies. You see, it should be something that someone else might have actually... Done.
I was in college. I was trying to find myself.
All you needed to do was look under the nearest man.
Maybe a serious relationship.
Maybe you're right. I mean, how long can I go on chasing these hunky 25-year-olds that are all looks and no substance?
Exactly, Roz.
Oh, I'm serious. I'm asking, how long? 3-4 years?
The airwaves for that one, didn't we?
Frasier, I want you to flash forward to tonight. It's sometime after midnight. Dennis Abbott and I have just had a glorious meal at Le Raleigh. Mm. Dennis has just asked me back to his penthouse apartment to see his priceless collection of silk sheets. And I lean over and whisper, I can't. I have to go to work in an hour. What is wrong with this picture?
Well, for starters, you at Le Raleigh. It's a 2-week wait.
So is Dennis Abbott. Frasier, I spent that raise already on my new diamond earrings. I love them. I love them so much I slept with them.
Well, Roz, as long as you're doing it for love, it's a step in the right direction. And while we're on the subject of tarts...
I'm really sorry about that call.
No, it's all right, Roz. Why don't you just run along for your date? I can handle the last 10 minutes here.
Are you sure?
Sure.
I mean, I'd feel terrible leaving you here alone in a lurch. We are a team, Frasier. You just say the word and I'll stay. Hey! Hold that elevator!
Make him tell who his playmate was.
Well, Doug, this is really none of your business.
Oh, but we got a pool going. So far, hot money's on Roz.
What?
Oh, well, thank you, but I think I have a little more self-respect than to have a quickie with a coworker on the air. What kind of slut do they think I am?
Hi, Dr. Crane. Did you sign this petition? Someone anonymously posted in the lunchroom. It's to the talented producers of Star Trek, suggesting a new character.
The all-powerful space vixen, Rosalinda. Four-breasted queen of the planet Rosniak.
I'll sign that.
Frasier!
Well, Roz, television will never improve unless the viewers speak out.
Thanks. I better go. Well, live long and prosper.
Oh, just go. This last-minute Christmas shopping is killing me. I never know what to give the men in my life.
Since when?
No! No, he is not going to move into my building. I won't allow it. I'm going to talk to him, Roz. Listen, I could use your advice. You've broken up with a lot of people. But what do you find to be the most effective thing to say?
I love you and I want to have your baby.
Good, I've got my fallback.
You know, I dated a guy once who got in trouble with the cops.
Notice the complete absence of gasps following that statement.
Okay, fine, you little weasel. Just forget it. I was going to help you. Maris can just rot in the slammer.
Oh, Roz, I was joshing. I know how you enjoy our little byplay. That weasel line, ouch, touche.
You know what? You're even more annoying when you grovel.
Zing, got me again.
Roz, if not for his sake, then for mine, please.
Okay, for you. My friend Phil had some major traffic violations, and he was so freaked that he called this guy who, you know, fixes things.
Sounds just a tad shady, Roz. You mean he went to some hoodlum?
Well, I wouldn't use the word hoodlum in front of him. Just think of him as someone who makes wishes come true. Like a fairy godfather. Another word I wouldn't use in front of him. Here we go, Jerome Belasco.
Oh, Roz, you are an angel of mercy. How can I repay you?
The next time you think of some witty little thing to say about my sex life or what I'm wearing, just keep it to yourself.
Consider it done.
Well, I can see the unseasonable sunshine has done nothing to improve your mood.
Well, how would you feel if you just lost the love of your life?
Well, alimony aside, I found it rather liberating.
My car wouldn't start, so I had to take the bus. We're all crowded on there when suddenly I smell Lagerfeld, and I look up, and there he is.
Karl Lagerfeld.
His name is Gary. I don't know his last name. Anyway, we got to talking, and you know, we were really connecting. I started to believe in kismet. And all of a sudden, all these people want to get off the bus, and I'm in their way, so I get off to let them out before I can get back on. The damn bus drives off. Out of my life forever.
I'm sure another one would have come along in 10 minutes or so.
Talking about the guy.
So am I.
I certainly hope my little gamble turns out as well as Roz's has. Or even better.
Just a little nervous today, okay?
Oh, really? Trouble on the dating front?
I'm not that shallow, all right? It's about my hair.
How bad could it have been? Ever want a saddle?
Do I have to answer that? Lately, everyone I know is settling down, getting married, having children. What am I doing wrong?
Well, do you want me to answer as a friend or a therapist?
As a friend.
See a therapist.
Frasier.
That is the last man that Roz should be with.
Don't worry. Knowing Roz, he won't be.
Roz, listen, I'm going to the opera tomorrow night. You didn't happen to remember to bring my...
Your opera glasses. I'm so sorry. They completely slipped my mind.
I wouldn't really mind if you hadn't borrowed them to ogle that bodybuilder that moved in across the street.
Looked once or twice. It's not like I copied his name off his mailbox so I could look up his number and call him while he's in the shower so I could watch him cross the room naked to answer the phone from the picture window. That would be wrong.
I want them back. I refuse to squint through Pagliacci while you're trying to watch the magic flute.
If you don't come out in the next 3 seconds, I'm going to reach in there and drag you out by your ankles.
Hello, Roz. Playing hard to get?
Well, I certainly hope his tailor can fix the two holes he just burnt in his jacket.
They're not in his jacket.
Are you quite finished undressing him with your eyes?
Oh, please. I'm already looking for my stockings and trying to remember where I parked my car.
No, Roz, I would have thought that gentleman over there in the flannel shirt would be more your type.
Him? Oh, not a chance. See the way he's slurping his orange juice? Sloppy kisser. Now, you can tell right away the guy is no good in bed. He's so cautious. Look at the way he's blowing on his coffee.
I wasn't trying to cool it. I was simply blowing a foam hole.
You don't even wrinkle the sheets, do you?
Oh, I can't just walk up to a god like that.
Well, then find a subtler way.
In your vernacular, that would be what? To slingshot your panties across the street?
Foam blower.
Start again, and I'll just be quiet.
Can I ask you a favor?
Yeah, forget it. He's married.
Hey, that's pretty offensive. Why do you assume that's what I wanted?
Okay, then. What did you want?
Well, I don't know. I just wanted to get out of
here. Time's up. Oh, by the way, if you're so hungry for some good-looking athletic guy, why won't you go out with me?
If you're not at least this tall, you can't go on this ride.
I must admit, I find this all a bit mystifying. Do people really care this much about a basketball game?
Are you kidding? This is Seattle. It rains 9 months out of the year. We take our indoor sports very seriously.
Well, I know you always have.
You're a hero today, so I'm going to let that one go.
Pucker up, baby. I'm planting a big wet one on you.
Rodney.
Yes. You won't believe this. Last night, Roz insisted on taking me to this bar she calls the Sure Thing.
How flattering. They've named a bar after her. I'll leave you a number at Niles' cabin in case anything goes wrong. Oh, yes, and by the way, I frown on overnight guests.
Then you're not doing it right. Oh, wow. There's a guy over there checking me out. Mm-hmm. He's coming over here. Get out. No, it's too late. Just pretend you're not with me.
Hello, Dr. Crane.
Dr. Kagan.
I hope I'm not interrupting you.
Oh, no, not at all. I don't even know who she is.
Hi, I'm Roz Doyle.
And Dr. Stephen Kagan.
Yes, Dr. Kagan moved into my building about 3 months ago.
I love what I've seen of Seattle, mm-hmm. but I'm still finding my way around.
Well, Roz is an excellent tour guide.
Really? Mm-hmm. Well, if you have an afternoon sometime, maybe you could show me all the hot spots.
Oh, I think that could be arranged.
I'd be happy to. Mm-hmm. I'm free tomorrow afternoon. Here's my card.
Great. I'll give you a call. Nice meeting you, Roz.
Nice meeting you.
Dr. Crane?
Dr. Kagan.
Thank you, Frasier.
My pleasure.
Gorgeous doctor, and I didn't get you anything. So what kind of doctor is he?
A gynecologist.
That's not funny.
What's the matter?
He really is? Oh, God, I can't go out with a gynecologist. Do you know what they do all day?
I have a general idea.
I'll see you at home.
Hey, would you date a gynecologist?
Oh, God, no.
See?
Yeah, I wouldn't even date a dentist. Hands in people's mouths all day. And after watching Eddie's complete physical, I'm not anxious to date a vet anytime soon either.
I would have thought that familiarity with a woman's body.
Now that I think about it, what have I got to be happy about? I mean, I know that has nothing to do with Eddie, but maybe Frasier picked up something from contact with me.
He wouldn't be the first one who... Oh, I'm too depressed. All the tables are taken.
No, there's one right there. Dibs on that table.
Roz, Niles was here first.
No, but I'm meeting someone. Please, guys.
So, who is it? Another one of your till dawn do us part relationships?
No, Tor. This is a guy who I think really has a chance. I can sense a lot of chemistry between us. Morris.
Hi.
Dear God, when did you two even get out of my sight?
You blacked out for 30 seconds after he gave you the shot.
And you chose this. Well, think about it. Walking the streets picking up trash, you can see how Roz would go with the familiar.
Niles. Apparently someone was a little bit jealous. After this weekend, you may have to give up your dating crown.
I once had 3 dates on a single Saturday and still had time to defrost my refrigerator and rotate my tires.
It's a wonder you could rotate anything after that. All right, I concede.
All right, good. Well, I think hugging is very healthy. I read somewhere that if you have physical contact on a regular basis, it can actually extend your life.
Well, in that case, you should outlive styrofoam. Oh, Roz, listen, I managed to get some reservations at San Gennaro's tonight. Thought we'd go celebrate your birthday.
Oh, that is so sweet, but I have a date with that waiter we met at lunch yesterday.
You going out with that guy?
I didn't have enough for a tip.
Keep in mind, the service wasn't that good.
What a slump your sex life has been in lately. I know you were hoping for a little, well, you know, action. You know, south of the border.
Roz, just because the last time you went to Mexico you were hit on more than a piñata doesn't mean that was the purpose of my visit as well. Well, good morning, Roz.
Good morning.
What the hell was that?
Oh, shoot, he's not even here.
Who?
Do you remember that guy who dumped me last month? I thought he was right behind me. I just wanted him to see me with another guy so he'd know how completely over him I am.
Good idea, Roz. That doesn't work. Why don't we get married and have some children? That'll really fix his wagon.
You probably remember him. Stan?
Stan, the smug stockbroker who kept calling me Frasier?
Oh, yeah. Oh, God. Oh, 1 minute we're hot and heavy, and then he just stops calling. It's so humiliating when someone treats you like you don't even exist.
Well, how can someone not hear the difference between Frasier and Frasier?
Yeah, that's what bugged me the most, too. Double espresso to go, please. Oh, my God, here he is. Hmm? Please.
Oh, all right. Hello. Hello, Nars. You know, this isn't what it looks like. Is it her ex-boyfriend is... Oh, just stop that!
Please, no explanation necessary. I assume at the next meeting of Seattle's Haven't Kissed Roz Club, it'll just be me and the Archbishop.
I'll save you the club dues.
Everyone kisses better than Maris.
I took one of those home tests, and it was sort of iffy, so I went to see my doctor, and he's going to call me with results later.
But, Roz, how?
I don't know how. No one is more careful than I am when it comes to birth control. But then again, even the best protection is only effective 99 out of 100 times. I can't beat those odds.
Yes, I suppose you've been dodging that bullet for a long time now. Oh, come on, Roz.
Well, I did run a costume and all.
For me? It'll be fun. You know you want to.
That's exactly the kind of talk that got me into this.
Oh, you? Well, I heard Frasier and Roz talking about it.
You don't seem very surprised.
Well, I mean, I'm fond of her, but let's face it, she's no Sunday school teacher. She's been around the block a few times.
Well, then let me be the first to congratulate you.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, Roz. Oh, God, it's so wonderful. You're going to make a great mom. No.
Well, I did the first step pretty well, and I wasn't even trying. You can fix, you can win Sam back.
Oh, now, Roz, that's preposterous.
Look who you're talking to. I've been down this road so many times, I call it the Roz Expressway.
I've heard that phrase before, but in a slightly different context.
God, there's that Connie from promotion. Every time she sees me, she hits me up for another charity.
You know, Roz, maybe it's time to set some limits. Good Lord, how hard can it be to say no just once? Oh, well, look who I'm talking to.
Thank you for this, Frasier. It's nice to know some things never change.
Do you guys know where I can get a cheap hotel room in a hurry?
Case in point. Goodbye, Roz.
I had my calls forwarded. I hope you don't mind.
Hey, Roz, it's Marco. I'm coming to town this weekend. You busy Saturday night? Late? Call me.
Obviously, Marco and I haven't talked for a long time.
Something tells me you never talked for a long time.
Some developer wants to build a strip mall there.
Well, they can't do that. That's a Seattle landmark. My God, Mark Twain gave a reading there.
Oh, yeah, I know that place. Used to have a boyfriend who liked to make out in the occult section. It's a long way to row C from the cancellation line.
Hang in there, guys. I wouldn't be surprised if you get lucky.
I'd be stupefied if you didn't.
I am so sorry.
The baby kept me up all night long last night. I'm trying to get her used to her crib, but she just hates to sleep alone.
Well, the acorn certainly doesn't fall far from the...
I have got to wake up. Oh, hi, Frasier.
Sarah. Why so glum?
Why else? The weekend's starting again, and I don't have a date.
Oh.
Do you know how long it's been since... You know. I probably forgot how.
Oh, no, Ross. I'm sure it'll come back to you. It's just like riding a bicyclist. Bicycle. Love to. It's just that I've got a date tonight with Nancy.
That's still going on?
Yes. We're going out tonight on our third date. You know the kind. It's like one of your first dates.
Oh, ha. Well, I gotta go.
All right. I'm listening.
Hi, Dr. Crane. My husband's having some of his friends over to watch the game on Sunday, and I think it'd be nice if some of my girlfriends could come over, too.
Sounds reasonable.
Exactly. I mean, it's just football.
Not football, Einstein. The Super Bowl.
Ah, that would be your doting husband now.
Larry, this is a private conversation. And for God's sakes, use a plate.
Oh, Sophie, why don't you put your husband on the line?
Pick up.
Hello?
Larry, I gotta tell you, I'm afraid I side with your wife on this one.
That just proves you don't know the first thing about football.
What I do or do not know about football has...
Okay, how's this? My wife's friends can come over if you can answer even one little football question. Like...
No, I don't see that that's necessary.
You're down by 6, you're on your own, 43 seconds left, what do you do?
Well, all right. You would... You would... Take your receivers... And line them up. And then throw a pass. A long, long pass.
Yeah, and what's the name for that?
A Hail Mary. Sophie and Larry, I hope you enjoy the game. In the meanwhile, this is Coach Crane saying, I'm listening.
I'm impressed you're so good at charades.
I'm impressed you could mime a virgin.
My God, that is really pathetic.
Obviously, you've never let someone you've grown to care deeply about get away.
Well, sure I have.
I'm not talking about when the migrant workers leave at the end of the picking season.
Where are you going?
Daphne has friends at the British consulate, and they're having a big reception tonight. She got us invitations.
Yeah? Who knows, Roz? Maybe you'll meet some English lord who'll make you a lady.
I think at this point it would take the actual lord to make her a lady.
I want to thank you both for making me and my producer hello. Feel so welcome. Is everyone around here as friendly as you two?
Well, hello there.
Some are even friendlier. This is my producer, Roz Doyle.
Dr. Nora, and this is my producer, George.
Nice to meet you.
Hello.
Follow me and I'll give you the lay of the land.
Let's just hope that's a figure of speech and not a sales pitch.
What you said to that single mother yesterday. For your information, I happen to be a single mom, too.
That doesn't surprise me after watching you pounce on poor George like a Kodiak bear on a salmon.
Stop! All right. If it's war you two want, it's war you'll get. Right, Roz?
You don't actually buy all this no-sex stuff of hers, do you?
Yeah.
Well, it's war!
Well, it's easy for you to say. How do you tell somebody that you're attracted to them, but you just can't sleep with them?
I guess you just say, I'll ask around. I had a date tonight. Got halfway down the driveway. He called me on my car phone and canceled. So I was too humiliated to go back in the house and face the sitter. So don't ask me why. I went to the zoo. You really want to feel good about yourself? Put on your best outfit and walk through the monkey house on a Saturday night. And be sure to stop by and see Remo the baboon, who knows all kinds of ways to have fun without a date.
I was just thinking about something. You know, it's funny how loneliness can make people behave in strange ways.
What do you mean?
Well, you know, do things that are sort of rash, you know, act out of character.
Oh, God, I knew someone would find out about it. Who told you? Did he tell you? I'll kill him.
Roz?
Oh, please, Frasier, don't tell anybody else. Oh, I beg you, it was one night, one lonely, stupid night.
No, what are you talking about?
You don't know?
No, what happened?
Nothing, I'll see you tomorrow.
Roz. Stay right here.
Now, you listen to me. I am your friend. You know that. I would never judge you. Now, just how stupid and lonely were you?
It's the last person I ever would have dreamed of. I just guess I haven't been... I haven't been dating much lately, and I've just been so lonely.
Oh, my God. You slept with Noel.
No! Oh, how could you even think such a thing?
Oh. All right, now listen. Just tell me, Noel. Who was it?
Nobody. It doesn't matter. It was a mistake. It's over. I just want to forget it ever happened.
No, Roz, listen, you know, we've all been there. Come on. You were just looking for a little comfort. It's all right. No reason to beat yourself up about it.
Take it, baby. I'm sorry I had to skip out before breakfast.
Oh, Bulldog!
Bulldog?
Bulldog!
Bulldog!
Oh, Frasier, swear you won't tell anybody else.
So you told the doc, huh? Because you just had to brag, huh? Hey! I don't blame you. I told a few guys myself.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God.
Gee, where have I heard that before?
I'll just leave you two alone.
I'm right behind you.
Gee, where have I heard that before?
Stop that. Look, Bulldog, last night was a mistake. I will regret it for the rest of my life. And if you ever bring it up again, I promise you, you will regret it.
Hey.
Your place tonight.
10 o'clock. Use the service elevator.
It is one syllable. What the hell is wrong with me? Well, I'm glad to see that you think it's funny.
No, I don't. I'm having a flashback to my summer of Ted, Todd, and Tad. Excuse me. I know this is a little weird, but my friend over there thinks you're really, really cute. He wanted to know if you two were on a date.
A date? Oh, no. Hank and I are just friends.
Oh, that's good news. That's really good news. Hi, Hank. I'm Ross Doyle. In fact, it's my first date in a month.
Whoa. You injured? You pulled something?
No. I'm sorry, Mrs. Wozniak. I know the balcony is not for sex play.
It's Frasier. And by the way, charming.
Frasier's interested in Poppy?
Well, I shouldn't be surprised. The subtle signs of attraction are lost on you, a woman to whom the gunning of a Harley engine is like a come-hither look.
You know what happens when you say no to a guy?
Yeah, sure.
You know, Ross, hearing Gil's little ditty puts me in mind that maybe we should just do an original song.
Well, my new boyfriend, Leon, is in a band. He could write one for you.
Well, actually, I was thinking of composing it myself. I'm not without musical ability, you know.
Could you at least hire Leon to accompany you?
I take it he's desperate for work.
Hasn't had a gig in months. Music is all he knows. He's not good at anything else, except in bed. Mm-hmm. It's what he does best.
Yeah. How long did it take you to find that out?
10 seconds, Frasier.
Oh, longer than usual. Oh, my. That is a literary 911. Wait. You joined a book club?
Why is that so hard to believe? I like to read.
What's his name?
Jason. Uh-huh. We met at a bookstore and he asked me to join his club. He's separated, but I think it's for keeps. He was buying Divorce for Dummies.
Sounds like a real catch, Rob.
So, you're with us tonight, huh?
Yeah, we rented a couple of sad chick movies.
It's not like you not to have a date on Valentine's Day.
Tell me. I usually try for a second seating.
Redecorating, you know, we should get out, you know, have some fun. Maybe take a cruise. You don't want to stay in your apartment cooped up with a bunch of sweaty workmen. Bon voyage. Maybe I could just drive up tomorrow and attend the panels.
Oh, Frasier, tonight's reception is the most important part. It sets the tone for the whole weekend.
Oh, come on. Last year, everybody just got drunk and acted like a bunch of horny teenagers.
Exactly. So stop yakking and start packing. Thanks for watching Alice, Lori. I really owe you one. Well, I just want to get down to this cocktail party before all the good men are taken. What? I just want to have a little fun tonight. No, I do not mean that. All right, I do mean that. Where did we go wrong? Rush hour Rita was draping herself all over you. And that news guy actually said to me if I gave him 22 minutes, he'd give me the world.
Yeah. Roz, you know, someday you're going to make a beautiful bride. Of course, your dress won't be made out of toilet paper.
Or be white.
Ready?
Well, it's nice to meet you all, especially whichever one's the bartender.
Oh, that would be me.
Oh, and a pretty little bartender you are.
Right this way.
After you.
Oh.
Rather walk behind you anyway.
I just love your accent. It's so sophisticated.
All right.
You have such a dirty mind.
And that would be a terrible thing to waste.
I spent an hour today on the seating chart. Everyone has some demand. Don't sit me near the band. You mind if I bring a friend?
Oh, my God, you can't seat me next to him.
Exactly. Every selfish, whiny little...
No, you cannot seat me next to Tim Walsh. I dated him all last summer and he dumped me.
He's going with my bridesmaid, Annie. I have to seat the bridesmaids together.
This always happens to me. Is there no place I can go without running into some guy I've dated?
I was reading about a Trappist monastery in the Amazon that they somehow built into the treetops.
Shut up, you big doily. Oh, come on, George, I'm desperate here. I promise you a good time. I mean, a really good time, if you get my drift. You might have mentioned I was on speakerphone. Which one?
Come on.
Why don't you go over and talk to her?
Please, Ross, come on. The woman's a perfect stranger.
Stranger? You know her name, you know she has a job, you know she's attractive. It's like an A&E biography compared to what I usually know going in.
So,
how did you two kids meet?
Actually, I just moved to Seattle a month ago. I live on a boat. And as I was pulling into the slip, Roz was standing right there on the dock.
Huh? Right there on the dock, you say? Well,
I do live next to the marina.
Ah, yes, yes, yes.
This is a bad idea. My hair is flat. Never have a good date when my hair is flat. If it's flat after, that's a good date. I have a date with this French guy, Jean-Pierre.
So that's it, huh? No Americans left.
Wow, Niles. Finally made varsity after 30 years, huh?
Yes, but it's not a real varsity jacket, Roz, so you're under no obligation to sleep with me.
See you around.
Take care.
So, Roz, I've known you for, what, 8 years now? And in all that time, I've seen you date hundreds of
careful.
Men.
Careful.
Oh, or dozens of men. Would you order some wine for us?
No. Let's get something straight. If you get drunk, the evening is over. And if you fondle, massage, or cup any portion of my body, the evening is over. Got it?
Man, you're like a total prude, huh?
Yes, I am. I discovered I'm not the only woman using my dog to meet men. Apparently, we also hunt in packs. Well, same as Roger, yeah. And we've been kind of going out for the last couple of weeks.
All right, tell us about him.
He's very sweet, mm-hmm. And he's a garbage man, so go ahead, make your jokes.
What jokes? I mean, why does everyone assume I look down on the common man?
Oh, I've got a good one. So, even in his off time, he's taking out the trash.
Technically, that's really more about Roz. Now, if I were to make a joke about him, which, of course, I wouldn't, I'd say he has a thing for Roz's can.
That's good. I have a boyfriend now, Simon, so you can just lay off.
You what? I thought you would wait for my return. Oh, well. Let's have another go, then, for old time's sake.
We never had a go.
We didn't? Who was that, then?
Charm is the viscous grease with which he oils his flim-flam machine. A man will say anything to get what he wants.
Can't believe I haven't dated this guy. Frasier, would you please give this to Freddie for me? It's for a spelling bee tomorrow.
Ross, it's not a spelling bee. It's the national championship.
Oh. Ooh, when is Lilith coming in?
Well, actually, she's not coming in. She'll be watching the competition from home. Her victory dance at state finals earned her a long overdue suspension. So, what is this anyway?
It's a flattened penny. I found it at the railroad tracks once when I was going through a really bad time. But as soon as I picked it up, I started getting lucky.
Oh, so that's where it all started.
No, Why are you turning a nice gesture into something dirty?
I'm sorry, Roz. I know it didn't bring you that kind of luck.
Thank you.
Because that would be one tired penny. This is my son, Roz. The little bald candy man that used to fit right here in the crook of my arm.
Little bald candy man. That's adorable. I had a boyfriend who called him. Figured he wouldn't be here long.
Well, you certainly made an impression on me. I remember I kept thinking, who did she sleep with to get this job? And then I found out. Everybody.
That's a good one. But we're just warming up.
You know, there's a place down the street that is open all night.
Just like your mouth.
Just like your legs.
Wait up.
Hello?
Hey, Julia.
Julia.
You're going to the bike-a-thon, right?
Oh, don't embarrass her, Kenny. I mean, it's got to be tough finding a comfortable bike seat when you're such a tight ass.
This for a woman who pedals her ass all over town.
Yeah. Okay.
Yes, all right, stalemate. Well done, well done. Keep moving.
No, it sounds like a good position for you.
Right, because I get into a lot of sexual positions with a lot of guys.
I'm saying congratulations.
Oh, thank you. What's her problem?
Dear Lord, what happened, Roz?
Turns out the person who's interviewing me is a guy I've slept with.
What are the odds?
It was 10 years ago at a convention in Cancun. They were all hammered.
Oh, well, I'm surprised you even remember it.
Well, it's hard to forget when you wake up with a name tag on your pillow that says, "Hola, my name is Woody Wiswell."
Hi, Julia.
Do you mind? I'm trying to show Noel what I do.
Is that why he's on his knees?
Okay, everybody, bulldog to the rescue. Now, I don't want to say Roz has had a lot of sex, but she spent more time in her back than King Tut. Did you hear the story about the guy at KACL who didn't have sex with Roz? Me neither. But seriously, what's the difference between Roz and a dog in heat? No, really, I'm asking. You people suck!
It's not a roast, Bulldog.
It's not? I paid a guy at the Chuckle Factory $50 to write jokes for me.
When's he getting here?
And I wouldn't have any problem with you being my boss. After all, I know what it feels like to be underneath you. Am I right?
But I wouldn't be honest if I didn't say that this is a big loss for me. You were there on my first day at KACL, and you took me under your wing.
It's crowded under there.
I will kill you.
Roz, have you ever been set up on a date with someone whose name you didn't know?
Oh, please, I've woken up with dates whose names I didn't know. Sorry I'm late. Mm-hmm. The Cinco de Mayo traffic was muy malo.
Oh, yes, that's right. They closed some streets for the fireworks display. Well, happy birthday, Roz.
Happy birthday.
Whatever. Used to be I'd go out and get a little wild on my birthday. Now I go out and get a little dinner.
There's nothing wrong with dinner.
I know, but it used to come with sex.
Come on, Roz. Sounds like you need a drink.
Oh, that used to come with sex, too.
Sounds like we got another passenger on the SS-8 getting any.
Oh. Well.
Sorry I'm late, but I had a date.
Yes, I thought that was last night.
It was a good date.
The label says it's famously spreadable.
Funny, Roz, doesn't your label say the same thing?
What does yours say, Niles? May cause drowsiness?
Oh, by the way, I've invited Roz Doyle to join us. She's my producer over at the radio station. Well, I had no plans this evening. You know, I think the poor thing has a hard time meeting men. Anyway.